How you doing, everybody? Randy Richard in the shop. Anyway, kits. We're up to the what are called the tool holders. We have this 5/8 square by 4 inches cold rolled that we're going to use to make these tool holders right here. These two here. Here's the details. Get that in there. Now, these are turned to fit in the slide, and there's a hole in them, and it's at 7 degree angle, so a little bit different, and they have to fit in these holes here in the slide. So we're going to set this up on the Logan lathe in the 4-jaw, and we'll turn the end, then we can cut it off and then do another one. There's two of them we got to make. One's called an internal, one's called an external. For outside curves, or for a ball, or you could do for an inside one. But that's what the two tool holders are for. Over to the Logan lathe.
I'm on the Logan lathe with a 4-jaw chuck on here, and I've already dialed in the 5/8 square stock. Faced it, and I put a mark down here about 350 thousandths. That's as far as I want to go. And we're going to turn that end down to half inch diameter to fit into the slide. Okay, there we go. I did a little bit of just a touch of file work and a touch of emery, and that fits very, very nice. Just a tiny bit of movement there, but it just goes in nice and easy, but I think that'll be just fine for the fit. As long as it fits nice and tight also against the shoulder, which looks pretty good. Might have to break that edge a tiny bit more to get it to fit really perfect there. Or I'm going to have to do a little radius cut down in the crotch here between the face and the shank. And I'm decided to reach in there. I'm just going to put take a little bit out of that right in there. A little bit of relief in there. There, that fits better. Now it fits nice and tight against the shoulder. Yeah, I like that better. There's a small tapered flat on this shank part of the tool holder, and that's for locking it in the slide. And they suggest now to, after turning this, they suggest to file that small flat. So I'm just gonna set this, lock the back gear in, angle my file. Now, since I don't know exactly how far up that needs to be, I'm going to use the hole in the end of the slide to kind of gauge that. A little less than 1/8 of an inch at the top of that hole. So we're going to go up here, the shy there, a little mark. Now the taper reaches all the way down to the end, it looks like, in the drawing. So okay, good enough. Now we're gonna part that off. There we go, part off. Now we'll, there's a little flat. Now we'll make it one more of these. Use this for the parting operation. Before I drill the 7-degree hole, I'm going to set them in here together, and I'm going to make them the same, exactly the same height. They're only thousandths apart, maybe 10 or 15 thousandths, the very most difference. But I'm going to make them both the same and get rid of the little tits on them at the same time. We're going to put this 1/4 by 3/8 parallel in to set them up here for angle. I'm going to put my 7-degree angle block on top of that. Now the hole is in relation to what the side you put the flat on, so the needs to tip really away from the flat, or away from the flat, that it's going to be that way because that's the way the block I have block set. And that will put our hole at the proper relationship according to the drawing. We're just going to set it in there. Like that. Clamp that in and tighten the vise. Right. Now I also put the stop on right after I clamped that tight. I put the stop on against it tight. So when I decide on the drilling spot, right, I can be able to just change it out with the other one and put it back in the same place and be able to make them both the same. Now I've already, I'm using my back as my absolute, so these are 5/8 blocks, and I just came over halfway, so 5/16, so I'm already centered up in the y-axis. Spotting drill in, 1/4 inch one. I'm just going to eye it. There's real no dimensions on here about the hole other than the diameter is 1/4 inch. Depth of the hole or anything. Other than they show it, most of the depth, almost all the way down here to the shoulder. Reamed and cleaned out, and oh, that piston fit there, boy. It came out perfect. Okay, one more. So I drilled it a half. Reamed it a half thousandths over, and I think that's going to be just perfect. Since this high-speed steel measures a couple tenths over, anyway, so we're only talking, you know, maybe a few tenths, but nice fit. Get the oil out, perfect. There's the tool holders. I drew a line at 7 degrees with a protractor. From the top to match the hole, centered up the edge of that line is on the center of the hole, so I know where the, you know, where to put a center punch mark. I came a half inch down and I just scribed it with the calipers and then eyeballed in, making sure it's going to be in the middle of the hole, and a half inch down and put a center punch mark. Did it both of them. Now we'll drill it 19. A number 19 drill for M5 tap. Forgot to set up the camera. So I put the tool steel, high speed steel bit material in the bore of the tool holder. And so now you can see how that looks, right? 7 degrees off. And then I've set my tool post at 15 degrees. I'm going to take cuts, and eventually the piece will look like this. This is the first one I did. So we're going to whittle away at it. We're going to go until all the flat is gone from this end. See, that's the only one spot right now. So we'll go until that, just until this is all connected around the nose. There we go. We just, you know, got rid of it. So, and we're right down to the tip on the two sides back here. So we're good. Now, it doesn't look the best because of all the vibration you have with this thing hanging out here. So we're going to clean that up now. Pretty good. There's a burr, a little bit of burr around this top edge. When we take it out, we'll just buff that off. There we go. Two tool holders.
Tool holders are done. They came out really nice. I think they should work well. I also made the part 13, the push rod. Now this end is basically a round end or ball shape or spherical end, and the other end's flat. The 5mm set screw is going to push, oops, let me get in the frame. The set screw is going to push against it. So what they do is this is going to be inside here with a set screw behind it. That's it. So the set screw is behind the push rod and it'll push against the tool holder. So I'm going to slip the, I'll show you, I'm going to slip the push rod in, slip that in there, then the set screw goes in behind it. And you're only using one of these at a time, so you just leave it in there, and then if you use the other end, you just flip it around. Then it pushes, the push rod pushes against the flat part that we hand filed in there. So we'll just slip that in there. Extend it too much. So that goes in. And then you tighten this. That pushes against the flat in there. Like so. And that is that's very solid in there. That seems like a pretty good method. And that's actually nice and flush on the end. You can't even feel a difference. And then the other one, one's an internal one, you use one as an external. The other one would go in there like this, and the screws are on the opposite sides because these are made the same. Like that. So these came out really nice. And oh, and here's the high speed tool for the high speed steel stock quarter inch that we'll use to make the tool bits. We're getting really close here. Finishing up. A couple more things to do. Thanks, you guys. Thanks for watching.